evening, Dad.
Thank you, dear. See you tonight.
Leonard Schiller. He was one of the New York intellectuals, Bellow, Schwartz. To be honest, I was never really interested in that crowd.
I'm just putting the finishing touches on my new novel. I'd be happy to send it over.
Leonard, I respect you too much. This business has turned into celebrity confessions and self-help books.
Now, a young student.
Professor Schiller, I can't believe it's you.
I can't believe it's me either.
The Sound and the Fury would have gone out of print if Malcolm Cowley hadn't published The Portable Faulkner.
And you're going to save me with a portable Schiller. Is that the idea?
Something like that.
I don't think Dad's expecting you. He's working right now.
Maybe a little shake-up in the routine is just what Leonard needs.
We'll teach him.
When you start a book, do you have the story clearly in mind?
Never.
Is that what's taking you so long to finish your current novel?
Only those who truly live...
I want to be bold. I want to be Joan Didion, Joni Mitchell, Joan of Arc.
...can honestly write.
I can't stop thinking about my daughter.
You give him everything, and you ask for so little in return. You're secondary to his dreams, and you always will be.
You went into hiding, and you took your characters with you.
No, Miss Wolfe. They learned the cost of living only for themselves. You insult me by insinuating that I should write the same book over and over again.
Where are you?
I make my living writing and teaching. It's my world, and I'm faithful to it.
Your novels are out of print. Why do you keep going?
It's not something I can put into words.
I never told you why your books are so important to me. You give me the courage to live my own life.
Freedom isn't the choice the world encourages. You have to wear a suit of armor to defend it.
Starting out in the evening.
Do you think people will still be reading you in 100 years?
What I wonder is whether people will still be reading in 100 years.